senior. Okay, so for and the basic objective is that only, and for that purpose today we have invited one of the seniors, Mr. Anjali Kumar Rastogi. He has done his RHCSS from here only. And now we would, before we start with our open discussion session, I would first like to thank Anjali Kumar for taking some time out of his busy schedule. And I would like to ask Shankar sir to give a cordial welcome to Mr. Anjali Kumar. Before we start with the session, I would just like to introduce Mr. Anjali Kumar Rastogi to you all. He has associated himself with the progressive organizations that have always given him the scope to apply his knowledge and skills. Mr. Anjali has pursued his B.Tech in computer sciences. He has more than 4 years of experience in the technical field, which includes his production and application server experience and support. His certifications include OCP, RHCE and RHCSS. During his work with various organizations, he has traveled to Indonesia, Nigeria, Dubai, etc. Currently, Mr. Anjali Kumar is working as technical manager with AB Solution, Noida. So, now before we start the interactive session, first of all, a general question which any one of you would like to ask Anjali Kumar, so that I would like to ask Anjali. Anjali, I wanted to know that what is your job profile in your organization, current organization?
Yeah, our company is Instructor Telecom Products.
Okay.
We are working on the servers and the index platform for the MySQL databases. So the basic model is to support the call centers and to organize this setup so that a predictive auto dialing can be happened.
Okay. So right now as a technical manager, what are your duties and
KRA? In the current scenario, the job profile is includes to manage the IT team and to have a one-to-one discussion about the products, about the ongoing issues with the clients, and to rectify those on with a deadline and within the timeline.
Okay. And like, how was your experience with
NetworkNet? I had done 2 courses over here for the RSCS and it was great to have a sir like Alok sir. It was a very good opportunity to learn over here. Yeah, to go with the sessions one to one and to get a certificate which is nowhere else provided.
Like you have done your RHC, after that it was RHCSS. So how the Red Hat certifications, like higher level of them becomes a subsequent requirement when you are in a particular job profile. So how that becomes an important issue? Like you, as you know that we have done RHCSS, you are looking forward to
some
ESS. So how it becomes a necessity?
See, once you start your career, once you will grow up, you have to do major job schedules to manage the clients and handle them because the technology is going up. So you need to complete those according to your knowledge. So for providing the customer to satisfy their needs or requirements or to deliver projects, first of all you need to gain your knowledge.
Do you think that apart from the technical skills these days, like for the job skills, the soft skills are also required, like the communication skills, these are also equally important?
Yeah, those are equally important because when you are moving ahead with your career, they are one-to-one interaction with the customer or client, facing the client meetings or going to a seminar and all. You have to put in communication as well as how to communicate, how to react with the person.
So you believe that the events like these which we organize on a monthly basis can be really fruitful to the students?
Yeah, such kind of seminars will be very fruitful to the new engineers who are coming from the engineering or B.Tech and all and going to start your career in the IT.
Okay.
So what are required is guidelines or some more motivation or what path they should follow so that they can achieve their goals in their life.
So first of all, before you start asking questions and there is an interactive session, you would just give a brief introduction one by one. I would ask Yash to start. You just tell your name and your graduation and with subject or things and your hobbies. You want to pursue anything specific, so you can just go ahead with it.
Because once you have given your resume and you have mentioned all of the DNS, SCP and all, so interview has to ask that. Because if you are going to mention those into your CV, that interview pertains that you know all those things. Fine. Yeah.
Sir, actually, besides Redmond Linux, there are a lot of distributions of Linux. Like Ubuntu or a lot of
CentOS,
Fedora, a lot of things. And as you have said earlier, that tech support is also one of the biggest industry of this Linux and all.
Right.
And I've seen a lot of this type of tech support company using CentOS and all. So it is okay, is it okay with going with this RSC core certification, or do we have to pursue other things also?
Yeah, that is more important, because for Fedora or Ubuntu and for Linux and all that, you must have a basic knowledge of the Linux. So there is no any difference in the terms of CentOS or Linux, all that. All those are same, only the phenomena are different, means the commands might be a slight change over there. But the basic knowledge there, that is going to be same throughout all the platforms.
And so one more question is, in our country, so what will be the career base, basic, and for in the scope of Linux, what will be the, is it good market, or that's the biggest question that we have.
No, for what?
For Linux certification.
Yeah, so for getting a Linux job, most of the companies prefer the certified persons to handle those tasks, because Linux engineer is going to handle them or manage the server. That is life for the customer and the client, and containing the huge databases as well. So freshers without any certification or without the perfect knowledge of the Linux, they are not going to hire anyone.
So the basic thing is we have to go for RSC, then we can go for good job.
Yeah, if you are looking for a better opportunity, then you must be certified.
And sir, one last question, sir. What is the hottest topic of the Linux right now in the current market? Like after finishing RSC, what are things that we can go forward currently updated knowledge?
See, after completing the RSC, you can apply for the tech support, or you can apply for the junior system administrator. So such kind of for the freshers, there are a lot of opportunity in the market right now.
And what I mean is for higher certification, what is topic of the country?
See, in the current organizations, RSC is considered to be, yeah, perfect.
Okay. I would just like to add one thing. RSC, you should understand, it's the first step, it's not the last step. After doing RSC, you merely show that I have the basic skills of configuring a well machine. Now, if you consider a production environment, like I think all of you are doing RSC. Great. Couple of you might be on SA1, SA2 and SA3. In RSC, you will learn how to configure FTP, full stop. How to configure Apache, full stop. How to configure Xamarin, full stop. These are default configurations. Not a single server in any production environment run on default settings. Why?
Security is the issue.
Maybe. Security, because even the attacker knows the default settings. Right? So, RSE will merely tell you how to launch FTP. Right, sir?
Right.
How to launch Apache, how to launch some. But then these are the default things. And any attacker throughout the world knows what are the default settings. So, after RSE, as you have asked, a RSE guy will never get the job of handling the server straight away. You will be given the basic jobs of log monitoring, checking the events, doing routine jobs.
Mm-hmm.
If you are a RSE, I'm not going to give you the total command over a FTP server or a SAML server. No, you can ruin everything because you don't have those skills. You know FTP, but you don't know how to harden it. What kind of attacks might be there on the FTP server? Then you don't know how to counter it. Got the point, friend? So RSE will merely tell you this. Now, after RSE, as you have asked very rightly, you should be knowing how to harden the machine. What are the common attacks or the threats on FTP, on Samba, or any application? You might have heard about like SQL injection attacks and all those things. These are the common attacks, those are being done on the websites throughout the world. So now, how to secure your MySQL server? How to secure your FTP? So these things are taught at a higher level. You can go for server hardening. You can go for virtualization.
So sir, which path is good? First security, then virtualization, or virtualization then security?
Look, just try to understand this. Currently, I think no data centers are using the physical servers, right? They are all going virtual. Virtualization, then cloud. So the learning hierarchy should be RSE, then go for RSCVA, then go for storage, then go for your cloud, OpenStack, and other things. It should be like this. You cannot mix and match all these things. The first step should be RSC, then should be RSCVA. RSCVA will tell you how the data centers are managed virtually throughout the world. Physical machines nahi hai. There are no physical machines. There are no physical servers. All the servers are total virtual servers. So you will learn those things in your RSCVA. Then what about storage? You might have heard about SAN, NAS. You upload 1,000 photos every day on Facebook. How the Facebook is managing the storage? Yeah? They require, I think, terabytes of space every hour. Throughout the world, everybody is uploading pics. So how they are managing storage? So storage comes next. How the storage can be scalable?
But sir, for storage, Hadoop is there for
Hadoop is big data. Hadoop is not storage. Hadoop is data mining. Hadoop is what crores of guys are doing throughout the world. Then what are their trends? What are they looking for? And then they search from their things. And then they supply it to the companies that, okay, suppose I have got 1 lakh guys who might be interested in your product. So means Hadoop is that. But for storing the things, you need storage. Hadoop will be accessing the storage. But then what about the storage? Who will configure the storage? So storage comes next, then comes your OpenStack or cloud or anything. Got it? But RSE should not be at the end for any person who wants to make a real good career in Linux. You should, actual administration, I always say this, actual administration starts after RSE. RSE is for bacha party.
Sir, I heard that sir, security is totally dissolved from RSE.
Security certification is not there. RSE is a certification is not there, but security is always there. You can still learn those things.
So it is running under which?
No. We don't have a certification now. But still, we have got a couple of guys who are still learning RSCSS. You can train, you can learn the things, but we don't have any exam to give. You can still learn 333. You can still learn 423, 429, but we don't have exam. But for knowledge sake, you can go. Sir, please.
Apart from these RSE students, there are certain CCNA students also. So you also must be having a query. I mean, Yash, Vinamil, and the page, you are a CCNA student, so you want to ask something related to networking field and your prospects there, job prospects.
Sir, I want to know that where we go for networking or Linux administration.
See, that depends on which platform you would want to choose.
Sir, what is
the
opportunity?
Better, which opportunity?
Better.
See, better one to go into Linux. As far as the networking is concerned, those comes under that as well. Like we are providing support to the call center right now. So we are going to hire those persons who have a knowledge of Linux as well within networking basics knowledge to configure router, to configure switch and all.
And separately, we ask that how much opportunity is there for the CCNA students?
See, for the CCNA students, there are opportunities as well also, because every time any organization don't see that he has the knowledge of to complete the good knowledge. Like he may be much well versed in the Linux as well as in the networking. But there are platforms where both knowledge is more appreciable.
So, as
we
were discussing a short time back, that you have started with
the
salary of 5,000.
Yes, see, the major concern is that our officer, we went for an interview, interview was written. Then when he faced the HR, then he said, I need 20,000 or 40,000 as I start. For the starting, I said, okay, I'll be. None of the organization is going to hire you for 40,000 except IBM and all. So salary is not a concern to get your career start. First start your career, whatsoever, if that job of IBM is suiting you, then must go for that. Gradually you will go up. Like I had started my career with a 5,000 as a stipend. I gradually move on, I had done so many projects in abroad as well, like in Indonesia, I went for Dubai, Nigeria and all. So gradually you will go up. I worked as a junior engineer, then I moved to a network engineer, then I moved to a senior engineer, then I moved to manager, technical account manager, then currently I'm a manager. So gradually there is a salary hike as well as your career growth is there. But you need to sustain over there. In current market, there are so many guys who are seeking for a job from the last 2 years or 3 years. He has done BTEC in 2011 or 2010, but they are seeking a job. If you have a gap in your starting your career and your whenever you have done your BTEC and all, so if there is a gap of 1 year or more, none of the company is going to hire you as it is.
What do I need to do then? Like by career, I'm having 3 years of gap. So
see, for having a gap, you need certification. That for that those time being, I have done these certifications. I am still learning it at technology. So I have not done job. But if you are not doing anything and after 3 years, if you are going to the market to seeking a job, nobody will hire.
That is again very important thing, that you have to take up some job, and if you want to cover that gap, you need to have some certifications or some proper studies. That is important to compensate with that gap.
Because of any big company, if there is a gap in your career, they will leave your resume back here.
So again, these things are important for them. You need to consider these things. And any specific question you wish to ask the freshers? You are like doing your BTEC, I suppose, both of you. Right. So what do you think? Right now it's your training period. So after that, what do you wish to do? You want to continue with the Linux field or what else? You also.
Actually, right now I'm working in IT for the last 2 years, and right now I've done RSC certification. Recently, I'm trying to on Linux platform. Before it, I was working on Windows platform as well as Linux also.
Mm-hmm.
But right now, I'm trying to move on totally Linux platform.
Mm-hmm.
So, how can I can just only get a job on Linux platform, good job on Linux platform? What is the preparation?
See, for having a 2 years of experience,
yeah.
If you are working on Windows and Linux board,
yeah.
Platform, if you are going for an interview or if you are putting your headlines in your resume and all.
Yeah, I'm showing, sir, I have 2 years experience, but they put a question, a lot of question, which is totally plus of our mind. So, just I'm asking.
See, they will not plus your mind, but if you are having a 2 years of total experience, then how much years of experience or how many months of relevant experience of your Linux have, you have to mention over it. Means total experience is a different task and relevant experience is a different thing, isn't it?
Yes, sir.
So you have to tell the interviewer that I have a total years of 2 years of experience, but I have worked on Linux 1 year or 6 months only. So then the interviewer will ask you according to that. But if you will highlight that I have worked on Linux 2 years, then he will ask according to.
Actually, in this situation, they offer me for a little amount of salary, which I am unable to survive myself in Delhi NCR locations. That's why I'm asking that I would say.
Yes, that is also concerned.
Yeah, they offer me from beginning grade also.
That happens. Because any company, if you are going to hire you for the 2 years of experience and actually you have only 6 months or 1 year of experience, then they are not going to give you a salary for a guy who is having a 2 years actual experience.
Yeah. So I want to know from your side, which kind of preparation I have to do for myself, which kind of technologies using on outside of.
Yeah, see, so for that, if you are going to for complete those compensation to get a salary same wise,
yeah.
So you have to learn Linux more deeply.
Okay.
Because RSC is a basic thing.
Yeah.
Thereafter, you have to move on. You have to add on to your skills. Like I had done RSC, then I had done RSCSS right now. Before that, I had an Oracle certification as well. I am a 9-8 NGO Oracle certified professional as well. So you have to move on with your career, learning the new technologies whatsoever in the market. I had done MySQL, OGRV, SQL. So all these are the markets what current industry is working with. So you have to well versed with those technologies. Then the company will pay you higher. If you are going to be an all-rounder, then of course they will give you a big salary for it, or they will give you a higher post accordingly.
Just I want to know about the which kind of preparation I have to do myself for Linux startup platform, which I like that I have 2 years experience and I want to work on initial level up 10 plus salary. Then how can I have to start up to prepare myself for Linux like mail server, which kind of
servers
are going
for the freshers in the Linux market, 8,000 to 10,000 is applicable for the freshers. If you are having a 2 years of experience and if you are seeking a job in the Linux market, then you must know how to configure it and how to make them protected by the intruders as well. Like if you are going for mail server and all, then you must know the sendman and all.
Yes.
What is SQL and all. If you are going for the administration part, then server monitoring tools, you know, there are so many tools for all server monitoring. You have to learn those things as well. And this network security is the major concern for any of the organizations.
Sir, there is one case. This is with I think Ravi Kant. We would like to share it. Actually, I don't want to mention the name of the company, but that company was earlier working with Windows.
Mm-hmm.
Now, what they wanted, that person there, concerned person asked me was, that we wanted an implementation of Linux from like switch over from Windows to Linux. So for that we initially want interns, and once that implementation is there, then we can hire some system admin or we'll take someone from them. So that way freshers would do. Now in that case, I had sent Ravi Khan, but he said that after 2-3 days, it is just not possible for me that being a fresher, I can do this thing. So I just really want to know that, is it not really possible for a fresher, and what kind of things they are asked to do?
What sort of
things they are looking
for? Yeah, skill set they are looking for.
They are looking for like we have to make a server from where the, all the data is stored actually. Live itself, and after there is also for the one server that stores the backup of that. But they actually they didn't tell about that what we have to do. Sir, I also have got knowledge.
No, suppose they had divided two servers. One is production server, one is for backup server.
Yeah.
Then what is the task?
Sir, we don't know what to do about that.
There was like configuration.
If someone told me that we have to do FTP server, make FTP, Samba, whatever, then we can do. But sir, there is no one to
guide them actually.
Guide us what actually we have to do. That is the main problem.
So in that case, they should hire some experienced candidate who has worked with...
No, that is not as important that he is a fresher, he is not capable of doing those things, but the concern as Vaikan is telling that he doesn't know what to do.
That person doesn't know. He says that just do this thing for me. Now what exactly he wants, that is not very clear.
If the thing is not clear, even a senior person will go over there, he will not able to do anything.
Yes,
anyone else?
If anyone had any query, can ask.
Any CCN student or can have issue with
I have changed to sir, I had the net profile I'm
If you go for bigger companies, they will hire only the BE and BTEC. They will not go for the BC and all. If you go for the middle-range companies, they might be hire the BC as well. So they have their terms and portfolios. And there is no any shortcomings for that you are not BE or BTEC. In Indian market, there are so many opportunities for the BC, BE as well, or for the MCA. But the major concern is your technology knowledge. How much you are well versed with your technology or your platform on which you are going to work out.
So like you usually take some of the interviews also most of the time.
Yeah.
So if you could advise them that how they need to prepare for the interview.
For the interview, what the basics things are, the basics must be clear. And whatsoever you are going to write on your resume or to highlight the platforms that you have worked on, that should be well versed. Or you must at least know what it is. Like I has taken a one interview, that he has written that I have done a PXE installation and PKE installation and all. When I asked them, what is it, they did not know. So there comes, or if you have writing the Samba, SendMail and all. So at least the configurations you must know over there.
So what you will do usually is that you ask me that ma'am give me a sample CV so that we can prepare, and what you do is
you are almost copy-paste things, and that is the major problem.
One of the major blunder, and as the sir said, like, you should be enhancing your technical skills. Samba doesn't end what is mentioned in your RSC, it doesn't end there. If you think that I know Samba because I know all the commands and the options, those are mentioned in my RSC book, you are wrong. how many of you are subscribed to YouTube channel? How many of you are viewing the videos regularly? How many of you are constantly connected to the Facebook page and the tips and tricks? How many of you are actually doing those things and checking whether it's working or not? These are the resources what the sir is pointing out that we are trying to give you extra. But it is now again up to you guys whether you want to learn from it, embrace it or leave it. Please be connected on YouTube channel, check the videos. We have got the videos, those are not covered in any standard curriculum and you are not paying for those videos, those are free. It's a free resource, please connect on it. Please connect to Facebook page, I normally update a tip every day. Today only I had given a small video, if any of you have seen, how to do SSH. I hope all of you know how to do SSH. How you do SSH? You open up a terminal, you do SSH, root at the rate IP address, hit it. Right? In the video, I had shown you how to do SSH via browser. You don't need a terminal. Now, these things might help you getting a job, isn't it? Because you know something extra. Think of it, doing SSH from the browser, from the Chrome. You don't need to open up a terminal. It's a 7-minute video. It can be a lifetime learning, yeah? Go through it, it's free resource, access it, please. And how many of you are still like have joined those comms classes with ma'am? Anybody here? Ma'am? We have to be.
Maybe a few of them are going to start from 7th January.
Means any student who is already in India?
First Yash and Anil will be joining. And Vineet will be joining from 7th.
Change. Look. You might feel it blunt, you might feel I am rude, but it is in benefit of you, change the way you look, change the way you speak, shave karo yaar, Gillette use karo, shave it, look clean, isn't it, look clean, look good, like enhance your comm skills is something that I can give you RSC knowledge, I can give you RSCSS knowledge, but ultimately you guys need to face the interview. There you need to speak. If there you are not able to speak, then the whole, like the 3 months or the 4 months that you had invested, time as well as the money, is waste. In the last meet also, I think last to last, I had given a very small tip, try to remove regional accent from your language. If you belong from UP, it is there, Bihar, it is there, Haryana, it is there. Remove your regional accent. Do whatever you want to do. Speak in front of mirror, yeah. Talk to your student, like your friends, but you should remove the regional accent. If anywhere you are found with regional accent, no matter how good you are in technicals, I'm not going to hire you. This is the blunt truth. Accept it. Start working on it. You are working on Linux because you don't know the technology. Then why not work on your comm skills? Why not work on your presentation? It is again a part of your personality. You sell as a whole package. Isn't it? Soft skills and hard skills, they both combine. Hard skills is my RSC, RSCSS. Those are hard skills. Soft skills, or we call it people skills. The skills that is required to interact with my team members, the skills those are required to interact with my boss, my superior, my junior. If I'm not able to convey my things, no company is going to hire you. As sir has told you, you are the face of the company. If you dream of being like employed in Google or Yahoo or like say IBM SCL, then once you are with SCL, then you represent SCL. Now SCL wants that the person should look like a guy from SCL. He should not look like a person from a narrow place shop, right? It's blunt, but it's truth. Whether you want to join the classes or not, I'm not at all bothered. Don't join the classes. Do it at your end. How many of you have got a habit of reading newspaper? How many of you? Every day they read new newspaper. Come on. start reading newspaper, Times of India. I recommend to you it because the language and the English is very good there. Start reading it. Reading is a very good habit. Start reading it. You all are aspiring for jobs. You have got the knowledge, but you cannot communicate. Then the frustration comes. Sir, RSC ladke bhi sara kuch nahi hota, bekar. Bekar RSC nahi. Aapke ek effort jo aur aane chahiye the, wo nahi aaye. Right? Start reading habit is something that should be there in all the technical courses. Start reading newspaper. Start talking to your batchmates or classmates in English. Small words, jumbled up. Start it. Start. Take the first step. Start asking questions in English, at least do this. Let the sir answer in Hindi, English, French, Japanese and these both. You should start asking questions in English. Chote chote words. Galat aega. Isse jyada to kuch nahi hoga. Start to karo. Ab tak kya ho raha? Kuch nahi ho raha. The major problem or the major feedback that Devika is getting from the companies is that your students are very good in technicals. But they are not able to come up to the technical round. They are screened out from the initial rounds only. Those are your English rounds, comm skills rounds,
aptitude test,
reasoning. Got the point? Operation rounds or the technical round is at the end. You are screened out of or filtered out at the very start. Start building those things. Don't join the batch. I'm not at all marketing here for the batch. Don't join it, be at least bothered, but at least start doing it early at your end. And if any time you feel that me or Devika or we as a company can help you out, feel free to talk to her. She is always available with all the good advices and all the things. At least every day come to ma'am and say, ma'am, good morning, speak a couple of words, couple of sentences, start with this, what's the harm? But jo hitch hai na apne andar ka bolne ka, वो निकालना है, isn't it? You do it and believe me, might be sir will hire you in the company, right?
That could be the best
thing. I'm always.
So, any more questions? Any doubts? So, I hope that this session is some kind of productive for you all.
Yes.
Eye opener. For some students, okay, so good enough. So again, I would like to thank Anjini. And at the same time, we'll definitely be in touch. And probably next month when we'll be here with some new event, with some new person here, new speaker here, you all would be here to get some more tips, some different tips all together. Okay, thank you all. And before that, just a token of appreciation, sir.
Ma'am.
No,
okay.
Sir,
okay, I'll do.
It's my honor to. It's like something he has given us his time, and so it's a small token of appreciation.
So you just wait for a while. I'll just note down your names and.